In this video, we will be discussing Keyword Efficiency Index, or in short, KEI. Many people new to marketing think that this is the magic formula to achieve high ranking and thereby a steady stream of income. Most keyword tools use it as well, and the claim is also supported by many new bloggers in internet marketing that says this is great. I say that people who say that the keyword efficiency index is great without telling any of the drawbacks is either out to cheat you or they just don't know any better. So let's look a little bit closer on keyword efficiency index. It is calculated quite simple. You simply take the number of pages that have this keyword in and divide the number of searches. Usually you find the number of pages, like if you search in Google, it says number of results and you can put it here. To get a more accurate number, you put it in quote when you search. Then the number of searches, you can find it in many different ways. You can use, for example, AdWords free keyword tool, where it will get an estimation either in your local market or in global, the amount of monthly searches. Let's give an example with a bit of numbers on. Let's say we find that there's 224,000 something results and 821 searches a month. Then you take the 225,000 something and divide it with 821. And then you get a KEI on 273. That means that for each searcher, there will be 273 pages competing for one searcher. That's basically what KEI says. Let's look at a more realistic numbers, and that would be something like 11 million something and two searchers a month. And let's give a KEI on 5,600,000. Let's look a little bit closer on what happens when the numbers change. If you look at the searches here and we say the number of searches going to increase, then the KEI will fall. And we are happy about that because a low KEI means that there's less pages competing for each searcher. If the number of pages increase, then the KEI will increase as well. We don't like that because that means more pages competing for the same number of searches. But when you calculate KEI, there's a lot of things that you have to take into consideration. And some of the most important I will go through here. First, there's the position of the words. If it is in an unnatural order, you have the problem that usually it won't be written in the text in many pages and therefore it will give a low KEI. But in reality, it might not be like that. Let's look at an example. If you search for keyword report, you get 534,000 results in Google. If you change the order, then you get report keyword, and you will only find 29,100. And you're gonna ask yourself, is there 18 times less competition for report keyword than keyword report? And your answer is probably gonna be no, because if you search in Google, you get more or less the same results in top 10, and that's what you're competing against. But if you say there's the same amount of searches for each of them, then there will be the KEI will be 18 times less for report keyword. So always look if the order is unnatural and it will raise a flag and you have to think about, is this a good number? Then you have to look at the number of words in a keyword. Let's say we have two keywords that have the same KEI. One have six words, the other one have three words. many times the likelihood of finding all six words by accident in something that is not about this subject or answering these questions is smaller than just finding three of the words, the combinations. So therefore, longer keywords have a tendency of having a lower KI, even the competition might be the same. Then, if you look at the numbers, there's a lot of insecurity. You can look at the number of results. If you search for something in Google and click refresh, you get a different number. It more or less is an interval. Number of searches, there's a lot of insecurity. One thing is that Google might not want to give the right results or other sources. Another one is that there's a lot of robots, crawlers, looking for information out there, and they're difficult to convert. I'm sure there's crawlers out there just to find information to calculate KEI, and I'm sure you will have difficulty converting them. So instead of talking too much about this, I want to tell you the method I use myself to find keywords with a high value that you can rank for and thereby getting a good number or some good keywords instead of focusing too much on KEI. First, what I do is that I find long tail keywords that are searched. And here it's important that it is searched, so you don't combine it unnatural, but you find it from a source that look at the keywords if they're searched. Then I look at the keywords. And I look if they have high value. I look like, is it something I can answer? Is there some kind of, is it something that is like selling or buying or something where you can, where there's like exchange of money, where you can come like in between and probably you will be able to earn some money that way. You can also look in AdWords to get an estimation of what people want to buy or pay for a click. Then I look at top 10 results and I look, can I compete with these results? Are they good results? Are they for are they from sites that is difficult competing with? Or do I have a chance to compete with top 10? I don't care too much about the 11 million because I want to be in the first position or at least top three, and to be there I need to compete with top 10, and that's the most important. That's where you want to see if the competition is tough, and then I really don't care if there's 11 million or 224,000 something. Then I give people what they are searching for. If they have a problem, I'm going to answer their problems. If they want to buy something, I'm going to help them with that. And the same with selling and all that. When you do that, everything becomes much easier. And then, of course, in the end, you do your thing. You do your search engine optimization. You might do AdWords, social media, or whatever you need to do.